In this video, I want to talk about the concept of orthogonal projections. The idea being that we have a vector in a big vector space, and we want to project that vector down into a subspace of that original vector space. So let's start with the big vector space. So capital V is assumed to be an n-dimensional vector space. And capital W is a p-dimensional subspace of big V. So W is the subspace of V. Okay, using a process such as the Gram-Schmidt process, we can construct an orthonormal basis for this subspace W. So it's p-dimensional, so there are p basis vectors. So let's write S1, S2 through SP as the basis vectors for W, orthonormal basis vectors. Okay, so now what is the meaning of an orthogonal projection? So let little v then be a vector in the big vector space, okay? And then what is the orthogonal projection of little v onto W? So the orthogonal projection, right, of little v onto the subspace W is given by little v, so I'm going to say projected onto W, so I'll use this notation. So S are the orthonormal basis for W, so to project V onto W, what we do is take the, so these are supposed to be column vectors, but even though this works for general vectors, we're always working with column vectors here. So we do the V transpose times S1, so this is a scalar now, which is the value essentially of V along S1, and then this times the vector S1, so a scalar times S1, plus V transpose S2 times the vector S2, plus finally the last one would be V transpose SP times the vector SP. So that's the definition of the orthogonal projection of V onto W. The way to think about this is that it's the piece of V along S1, and then you multiply by S1, plus the piece of V along S2, you multiply by S2, etc. Okay, we can be even more concrete than this. So I wrote down the basis for W. We can write down a basis for V. And the basis for V, so W is a subset of V, so I can extend the basis of W to be a basis for V. So we extend the basis for W to a basis for V in the following way. So the basis for V then, the basis for V will be the original basis for W, so S1, S2 through SP, the p-dimensional vector space, plus the additional basis vectors we need to span all of V. So to here, we add T1, T2, and then the last vector, T, should be so that the total number of basis vectors is n, because V is an n-dimensional vector space. So this should be n minus p. Okay? So this is an extension of the basis for W so that we have a, now we have a basis for V. Okay, so let's repeat this process. So we have little v is a vector in V. So if little v is a vector in V, then we can write it as a linear combination of the basis vectors for V. So we can write little v, any vector in the big vector space, capital V, as a linear combination of these basis vectors. So I'm going to write it as a scalar A1 times the vector S1 plus a scalar A2 times the vector S2 plus a scalar A sub P times the vector S sub P, okay, plus another scalar B1 times T1 plus another scalar B2 times T2 plus the last scalar B sub n minus p times t sub n minus p. Okay? So any vector in the big vector space V can be written as a linear combination of these vectors, of these basis vectors. So in this notation, then, what is V projected onto W? V projected onto W, then, is just the piece of this vector that lies in W. So all of these terms that are proportional to the T vectors are outside of W. Only the S vectors lie in W. So V projected onto W is just A1 S1 plus A2 S2 plus A, P, S, P. And we throw away the T vectors. Okay? So that's the same formula here. You can see that because this V transpose S1, then, is a, this is V, right? V transpose S1, because the S's are all, these are an orthonormal basis vectors. So if we multiply V transpose against S1, then S1 transpose S1 gives us A1. S2 transpose S, S1 transpose S2 is 0. Sorry, we're looking at V transpose S1. So V transpose A1, S1 transpose S1 is A1. A2, S2 transpose S1 is 0, because S1 and S2 are orthogonal. AP, SP transpose S1 is also 0. P1 transpose S1 is 0. All of those vectors are also 0, because this is an orthonormal basis set. So this V transpose S1 is just A1. So this one is the same here. V transpose S2 is just A2. And V transpose SP is just AP, if this is what is V. So these are two equivalent formulations. I think the second one is easiest to understand, right? So the orthogonal projection of vector V in the vector space capital V is just the piece of the vector V that has, that lies in W, right? So the piece that's in W. So these are just the basis vectors of W. Okay. There's an important result that one can derive. Not very difficult, but I don't think I will do that here. This V projected onto W, so V projected onto W is the vector in W, right, that is closest to the original vector V, okay? So if you have a vector V, right, in the big vector space capital V, if you want to find a vector in W that is closest to that vector V, it's a different vector, but you want to find the one that is closest to V, then you project V onto W. That's the closest vector. That will be useful when we talk about the least squares line. So let me summarize. An orthogonal projection, then, is a way of projecting a vector in a bigger vector space onto a subspace of that vector space. Basically, you throw away all the piece of that vector that is not in the subspace. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.